On this little issue that we're doing, I bring you to the famous Todber Manor. I'm just having me cornflakes like I do every morning. Keep myself in, get myself all trim. And obviously, I think you all know by now, Todber is, you know, it's at its peak, if you like, in fishing. John, who owns it, has done a ridiculous job for this part of the country. You know, carp fishing, I think, it's probably sort of gone downhill a bit over the years for commercial fishing. There's a lot of F1s, but Todber is absolutely stuffed with carp. Basically, we're at the main site here. So this is where you do the draws, a shop and everything like that. Obviously, John's got lots of specimen lakes, but there's three new lakes, which I think are probably about 5-6 years old, something like that. And they are absolutely stuffed with carp from £2 to up to 12. I think there was one caught £27 the other day, which is ridiculous. There's obviously a lot of the carp in here are averaging, so I would say sort of between £3 and £5. They've obviously put some weight on over the last few years. It's a Fishermania qualifier, so you're going to follow me through. Hopefully there is three sites on, well, I'm hopefully going to actually draw the three lakes that are on the site here. These are the main three lakes that obviously get fished week in, week out. The weights are absolutely massive. You know, I think today I would be surprised if you don't need over £300 to win. A big 200 anyway, and I think you'll probably want a 300 to win. So I think personally, unless you draw the three lakes that are on site, I reckon you're going to struggle to get near to win it. Because there's three lakes here. There's two lakes down the road, which are called white posts. I don't think you'll be able to win on there unless people don't turn up and you've got some space and it's absolutely rigid. I think you're going to struggle to win. And also one of the specimen lakes are in, which is called Wobmill. I'm not sure how many pegs are on there. There was a 180 last year on there. And I know Perry lost a lot of fish as well, by all accounts. So there's a possibility on Wobmill, which is a specimen lake. If you get there, it's nice and it's nice and sunny today. It's going to get up to like 18 degrees. I think on the specimen lake, I think if you're going to be mugging, maybe a bit of pellet wagner fishing, you might have a chance. But personally, I think the three lakes on Todber main site, if you don't draw them, I don't think you're going to win. But anyway, you're going to follow me through the match. We're going to do the draw in a minute. Hopefully, fingers crossed, I can get on Hillview or Homeground Lake, because I honestly think, because I obviously come here a bit, I think they're the two lakes you're going to need to be to qualify.
This could be the best part of the day, this.
Rules of the fishery, £66 net limit. Go over, you get knocked back to £50 in that net. 16 metre pole limit and no standing up mugging fish. You can sit down and mug fish, but you cannot stand up and mug fish. Any questions? Separate net for silvers, well done guys. I see why I employ you. Separate net for silvers, and that is it. When you have drawn your peg, if you're parked over there, do not attempt to drive out until everybody's drawn or whatever, because otherwise you will run over your competition. And you do not want to do that because you want to win fair and square. So you are fishing 11 o'clock till 4 o'clock, so plenty of time. You've even got time to come and have a look around the shop, spend a few rounds, and go from there. It's a relaxed day, chill. If you don't draw the peg you want, still chill, because the sun is shining. There is people up in the churchyard today that would love to be here. So just chill.
Can we do some fun too?
Or can you spot? If you want to spawn, I've got nothing against spawning.
No, you can't spawn. No, that's against our rules.
I can see you over here,
Des. Finish, John. Terms of the draw, pay your pulls first, which is 20 quid, then you'll move on and draw a ticket, which will be recorded, obviously, so we can do the weight sheets. The names are in surname alphabetical order, so obviously you'll know where you are on the list. Any questions? No?
Okay, well, I'm ready to go. Todber Manor, peg 71 ash. Like I said, we're doing a bit of live sort of match fishing. What do I think about my draw? Outside chance, very outside chance, really. There's some good anglers that come here all the time on real good pegs. And I think Ash Lake, even though I'm on one of the three lakes that I wanted to draw on, this was probably the lake the least I wanted to be on. There's tons of fishing, as we all know, with Todber. The weights are just mega, you know, ridiculous fishing sometimes. Weights in excess of 500-600 pounds, which is just a disaster for me personally. But the plan of action is really feeder to start with, feed the pole line. The thing is, you've got to come here with a very positive attitude with the weights that you need. That I have drawn on the site, which is the, like I said, which is one of the three lakes I wanted to be on. Obviously, if you draw it white post, which is down the road, and one of the specimen lakes that are in, I think they're really going to struggle to win. I honestly can't see them winning. Maybe on the specimen lake, if someone gets on the right peg and they're all shallow and they catch them shallow, there's an outside chance. So really, yeah, I'll run you through the match as we go. Obviously, we're going to catch some fish, whatever happens. I've got lots and lots of bait with me because I haven't been here. I've come here a couple of weeks ago. And there's a lot of maggot fishing. There's lots of people chucking in maggots, catching shallow. And if you are on a lot of fish and that works, they're going to be very, very hard to beat. So fingers crossed. Obviously, I'll run you through as much as I can. Rigs. I've decided to fish with pellet feeders today for the simple fact is they're really, really quick to load up and get out. And that's what this is going to be about, this match. It's one, you're going to have to, you know, hopefully have some fish in your peg or a lot of fish in your peg. Two, you've got to catch them quick because on this lake, the average in here are not as big as home ground in Hillview. You're going to need probably 30 to 40 more fish, I think, on this lake to compete with the other two lakes. And to do that is going to be difficult, especially if the fish don't want to play ball. There's not a lot of fish moving, which is unusual for this lake. Normally you see a lot of fish topping. The wind is blowing down the other end. That's my fishing at the moment on these qualifiers. I seem to be drawing the wrong end of the lakes. Even though I have a good day's fishing, you're just not in the right area, especially this time of year when they're a bit moody with spawning and stuff. But whatever happens at Todber, we're going to have a day's fishing. But I have set up to try and win, that's for certain. I've not come here to try and win the lake. I've come here to try and win the match. So anyway, fingers crossed, and we'll keep you updated as we go along in the match. Well, that's it. Obviously, I'm going to start on a feeder, obviously you can tell. And hopefully we'll get a run. I mean, it's always gambles, obviously, what you're going to start on. And hopefully we can catch, well, the plan is really, is fish the feeder. Try and get the fish shallow, short, or as short as possible. Got two options. I've decided to fish with maggots, which is what the big weights have been coming out on, really. Like I said, Todber is one of them. You can do a lot of things. You can come here with meat and corn, you can come with just hard pellets. I've got a bit of that as well, but realistically I'm looking to fish, try and catch the fish shallow and short and in the edges later on. And but I'm really looking. I might have started wrong. But I'm hoping to get some fish like early on the feeder if I can. But let's see what happens. There we go. So first bite. Decent fish as well. I'm actually fishing, that's the nice thing about on here, sometimes the feeder fish can be quite big. So I've got a 10 foot SL, pellet feeder on, ICS pellet feeder, little 4-inch hook length, and then I've got my bandoms. Obviously, I've got different hook baits, but lit Richie, just trying to stick with bandoms if I can. Good fish that. As long as it stays on. They do come off here, they're an absolute pain. They're really like funny fish here. You've got to sort of take your time and it's not really fighting this fish either. It's a bit wallowy. They're the ones that normally come off. Don't really want to say that, but that's a nice little start. Probably 7 pound, I expect. I'm trying to dig his head into the. They are so strong here as well. That's what I was saying, that's just snap me up length. Trying to get the hook out of it because they're just an absolute nightmare. So you've got to have plenty of kit. A little red bandom on, pink bandom. Get that line down, click your 7 pound. Little fish bite that, I think. Got a 30 gram feeder on because it can get windy on here, so. And I also want to hold it over against that island, make sure it's pinned on that shelf. Using me to stopwatch. Just got some 2 mil fins. Soaked right up, because I am fishing with a pellet feeder today. I know it's crazy, but a method feeder sometimes is just too slow when you're trying to catch an absolute lot of fish. I know that sounds absolutely crazy, but that's the truth. Definitely more fish coming out on the pole at the moment than what I'm catching, but obviously it's all gambles, you know, which is a good thing in a way, because you just think you've got all that to yourself out there, really. Just chucking a few pellets on my short line just in case I want to go on that in a bit. Now that's my third one now. So a couple more bites since I last started. Only a little one, last one was only £2. Don't click that either, better click that. A few fish coming out. It's a good fish for on here, this one, really. £4. Never known fish like it here. You just get them in the net and they are so wild, it's a joke. Now that was on a, so I got some robin reds. I just put a robin red on then as well because I like them. So just burying the, trying to bury the length in the feeder. So quick with a pellet feeder, that's what's so good about it. Straight in. Get that line down. On your rest, little tweak. Obviously get your stopwatch going. Loose feed some maggots. I've decided to loose feed maggots. Catapulting them at the moment because obviously every peg's in, so so I said there's a lot of little fish in here. They're catching quite small fish on the pole, short. I'm hoping, really, the plan is hopefully they'll come up shallow. If they don't come up shallow, you're not going to win anyway. So that's what I said at the start of the film, really. The plan is to get them up shallow. And that's where you're going to do a big weight. But this needs to go round, you know. There we go. Lovely bite, that. Not really fighting that hard, really. So excuse the crows. They're like wallowing today. I think that's, like I said, they're moody. Everywhere you go at the moment, the fish are really moody. They're not, these are sort of wallowing on the top. Nice fish, though. Getting on for £4, that one. Let's get back out there as soon as I can. You've got to try and turn off. It is one of them places, like I said, it is very, there's a lot of fish in here. That was about 2.5-3 minutes that bite. Feel a bit of bait on your pole line. Wind's a bit awkward, to be honest. It's going to be a bit of a pain to actually throw that bait there. I've got some slop mixed up as well. I haven't done that here before, but I thought it might be a good option to try and get them up shallow. So I've got 4 fish for £15 at the moment. Chucking it quite tight, and you know, there's always the option of chucking it a little bit off as well. But the bigger fish normally you can chuck, the tighter you chuck, the bigger the fish normally. Keep that bit of bait going in shallow. Trying to get out the far bank, this one. Average sort of size on here, like I said at the start of the film, they are a bit smaller on this lake. Average sort of probably 2.5 to 3 pounds, where on the other lakes they probably average 3.5 to 4, and quite a few bigger ones, and you know, that makes a big, big difference. So it's all right, you know. There is a few fish. There's, you know, it's probably sort of one of them to fish the pole or the feeder, really. But I've, you know, took a gamble to fish the feeder, just trying to build my shallow line up. I've not fishing on the bottom, you know, past a top kit plus one today, because I just think the weights you're going to need to win, you're just not going to do it by fishing like that. I either need to catch, like, one a chuck on a feeder shallow and then short late, or hopefully shallow, like, properly for the last God knows how long, really. Hopefully all day. Thank you. £16. What's that, then, a bag in? Yeah. Wind's perfect, though, for him, isn't it? Ball ache here, Ben. You won't know, mate, you won't know until the end. Got £22 and we've been going half an hour, so that's all right. And like I said, Todber is a very special venue with the amount of fish that are in here, and you know, very sort of privileged and sort of spoiled in a way, if you like, because it is that good. But every peg's in, so it makes a big difference, you know, when every peg's in on these venues. As we all know, there's no space, and having a bit of space today, I'm sure for some people, would make a huge difference. But you know, you can only fish your sort of peg, and that was a line of that. But they're not on the feeder straight away. Just you've got to wait a little bit for a bite. Even in Todber's mega fishing, they're not really on it. What I'm hoping for really is to obviously get the fish in a frenzy shallow, but whether that happens or not, we'll find out later. But that's my plan of action. I could have come here with, you know, pellets, fish like shallow with pellets, but the maggot is if they come on these maggots now, you can catch a huge weight very, very quickly. And that's me plan, hopefully. Fingers crossed. You can see I'm using Robin Med pellets. I've got £30, we've been going for 45 minutes. On the feeder, it's steady, it's nothing. I know £30 in 45 minutes for most places is amazing, but for Todber, it's sort of standard stuff, really. A few people around me have come off the pole, they've had a little spell short. I've probably caught more weight in them because they are a slightly bigger fish, I think. Had that £7 first chuck, and then they're averaging like 2.5 to 3 pounds. But it's just not, they're not sort of right on it. I know it's crazy to say that. But yeah, nice fishing. Just trying to, it's doing all right, you know, just going along, prodding along for Todber standards. Just gonna put a, just trying to vary from bandoms to hard, you know, just normal hard pellet, and then have a go on a little red pellet. Just trying to sort of find out what's a bit quickest, but nothing seems to be quick. They're not coming to the, don't seem like they're actually coming like to the feeder really quickly. It's literally like between two and three minutes for a bite, which is great considering, you know, every peg's in. And that's the issue you've got, is the room makes a huge difference. Even on Todber, it makes a big difference, even though the fishing is amazing. There we go. So that was on a hard pellet, that. Got to keep remembering to click your fish, keep forgetting. I'm pretty useless at all that. Oh, he's come off. That was the sort of quickest bite I've had, really, about a minute. Just hoping that this maggot goes, hopefully. I am catapulting out a bit for the wind. The wind just ain't good enough to throw it today. It's sort of right to left in my face slightly, and that's going to make a big difference. You know, people, they've got the wind right for that sort of fishing, makes a huge difference. So another one then, 40 odd seconds, which is nice. What's that, Billy? That's messed one of your keep nets up, hasn't it? Hey?
I'm not talking to you.
Why not? You just have. Nice fish, probably 4 to 5 pounds that one. It's got me clutch set. Like just right. Obviously when I've been out carp fishing with the reels, I sort of get the clutch set. Those 17 hook lengths. The ones we want, we get one of them every chuck, and we'll be in for a nice big weight. Put him down for 5, I think. Got a 14 KKM on. For some reason on this venue, I've always found that a sort of lightly, a finer wire hook seems to keep them on. Not as if I come here every week anymore. Little 3-inch hook length. Keep that bait going in. hopefully shallow. Whether it's going to work or not, I don't know. It needs to work to have a chance of winning, because I know some of the pegs on the other lakes, that's what they've been catching on recently. Maybe not at the start of the match, but late on. It's just a pain, that wind. Absolute pain. Just turn now, it's like blowing straight in our faces now. There we go, another one. So that's nice and steady. Bad fish again. Lovely fish, you know. I don't know how many John put in here a few years ago, but must have been a fair few truckfuls of carp. £3 that one, so that's £40 now, so it's building up all right. Nice bit of casting. Phil Taylor would have been proud of that. Zolt's nodding his head. He agrees with me, Zolt, don't you? Keep pumping them, that bait in, trying to, you know, shallow line. Like I said, I've set nothing up on the bottom out there. I just don't think it's going to be good enough to even do it, especially this time of year. It's just a bit pointless, really. You can probably tell I'm not feeding the edges and that at the moment. I've got to wait, you know, wait for that. Just don't. There's a lot of little fish in these lakes as well. There's a lot of little roach and little skimmers, and I don't want to be dragging them in me peg. I'm not worried about shallow, because obviously I'm pumping quite a lot of bait in there to try and get a big ball of carp. Oh, I missed that. That's a pity. Definitely a bite, that. Just didn't quite hook that. Just putting my pellets in quite lightly. Ooh. Just that wind for shallow is going to make it not good at all. Even though it will help the fish, probably, it's certainly not going to help throw bait, which is what you want to be doing, really. Well, we've been going for an hour and 25. I reckon I've got 60 odd pound, I reckon. Just over 60 pound. I've got a nice fish on here now. Everyone's catching an odd fish. But I'm doing all right at the moment, I think. Nice ghosty. These are the ones, these are like little bonus fish on here. You know, like three of the other fish, so you get one of them. Makes a big difference on this lake. Similar to the one that I had at the first chuck, that one, probably £7, £6 to £7. Just sticking with that pellet feeder. Nice fish there, that's the ones you want. I'll put him down for £7. straight back out. That's what's so nice about that pellet feeder when you're bagging. Just like that quick, you know, scooping them in. Just keep that bait going in shallow. So I don't really know what's going to happen with that. It's just a gamble. But really speaking, I was never going to do any good on the bottom there. Not to do any good in this match. That's why I've opted to do what I've done. I could have fished pellet shallow long, but you know, it's gambles at the end of the day. So I'm just hoping that keep doing that. If that don't work, it'll be a feeder stroke short pole and down the edge. And with no space, I really don't know whether they're going to come short and down the edge late properly anyway, but you don't know. So we're doing all right at the moment. Like I said, 60 odd pound, just under an hour and a half gone. But it is starting to slow down for everybody. I think everybody's now on the tip and it's sort of messed it up a bit. And that, like I said, that is the trouble with Ash Lake. Everybody's doing the same in a row. Where on the other lakes, you have got a bit more open water. The islands are further away from you. And yeah, you just need a bit of a space really, I think. Just trying to drop that one a bit shorter. Just loose feeding some 8mm over the top as well. Just trying to get a load of fish to be pegged really. We've been going for just hour and 45 minutes and I've got, I reckon, 70 pound, I reckon, which is nice fishing, but it's definitely slowed up now. It's definitely gone off. It's not as great as what I thought it could be on this. I mean, obviously on some days you're literally chucking the feeder out and they're actually having it sort of as you're sinking the line. That ain't happening today. Which it needs to be like that, I think, to do any good. There's a few people gone back on the pole, and to be perfectly honest, it ain't really happening. But you know, £70 in that hour and 45 is all right. It's good fishing. And I think this lake, well, the looks of it, I think it'll get harder and harder. Maybe until the last, maybe hour and a half. But I'm just going to keep plodding along. And yeah, just hopefully they'll come back and you can have a bit of a run. The last few fish I caught have been slightly bigger, which is quite nice. But it needs to sort of, you know, to keep going. You know, for the weight, this is like I said at the start, because of the weight that you're trying to catch, it needs to be constant unless you catch late, shallow, or maybe in the edges. And, you know, we don't know yet what's going to happen with that. You know, just like keep going. It's definitely slowed up for everybody on this lake anyway. It's just the space you need, everyone there. So I'm just going to keep, keep my eyes open to what everybody else is doing. And like I've always said on my films, you know, use the other people around you. Everybody's doing slightly something. Obviously, everybody's doing something different. I've not set up a method feeder today, which might be a mistake. I have put a little bit of ground bait in me pellet feeder just to try and make a little bit of a cloud. I have had a couple of quicker bites on that. So that's the sort of things that I do even with a pellet feeder. You can put a bit of ground bait in it or on the end just to try and make a bit of a cloud. But I think the pressure every peg in is going to make a big difference. And everybody set up everything today. You know, they've set up feeders, long poles. But just going to keep prodding along and not a lot else to report really, because it is just a sort of, at the moment for me, it's a feeder job. And hopefully they'll come on that pole late, but we'll see, and I'll catch up with you in a bit. Right, we are halfway through. I don't know, I've probably got about 110 pound, I reckon. There's a few fish starting to come up down the edge. Billy to my right's catching right down the edge. What weight you got, Billy?
85 pounds.
You've got 85 pounds, so I'm still in front. And the feeder seems to have got a bit better at the moment. Everybody seems to have come off of it, which is obviously giving me a little bit of bit annoying that I've pulled out of a few, but like I said at the start of the film, you always do. Obviously I'm just priming up my shallow line still, but whether that's going to happen or not, I don't know. I've not seen a single sign, no bow waves or anything like that to say there's no fizzing, even to say there's any fish on the bottom under it. So at the moment, it's pretty boring for you lot. Just carrying on with the feeder, because I've got it all to myself at the moment. Not really heard. Jack Stamp, who's one of the local guys who comes here all the time, he's drawn a real, real nice peg. Peg 60 on Hillview, which is behind me. And someone said he's got 120 pound. So, you know, I'm close to that at the moment. So, yeah, I'm just keeping going. Priming up my line. I've just started throwing a little bit of bait in down the edges because obviously they've caught a few round me. And yeah, it's pretty boring, just sticking with it. Just putting plenty of pellets through me pellet feeder, as many as I can get in it. And just chucking it a little bit short of the island as well, or the far bank. Seems to be better. So yeah, just still using my little stopwatch. Most bites are coming within 2 minutes. But I've got to be careful now with this sort of down the edge fishing. Because obviously if they do come in, the only thing is when I plumbed up down the edge, it's really shallow to my left. And I mean, nothing's come in. There's another one there, see. It's just starting to sort of get better now. That was out there for 23 seconds, so. Just got to take me time, get them in, or try and get them in. Like I said, I've probably pulled out of 5 or 6, if not 7 since we started. But that's the nature of the beast on here. They wrap themselves over the line. You can feel the feeder come off. As long as they're nodding like that, they're fighting really hard. They're not fighting that hard today on the feeder. They're really sort of plodding around like that. That's a classic of what happens on here. You look at your everything's bang on. And you've just got to put up with that a little bit at Todber. Everybody's been moaning about it, apart and me. Because every fish counts, as we all know. So I'm just going through the motions, just trying to get yourself in the best rhythm as possible. Get me maggots, blasted maggots at like 10 meters. The wind's just blowing them everywhere, to be honest. It ain't good. I've not seen, my line's obviously going through that. And I've seen a few people go out shallow. It just ain't happening. And yeah, at the moment, I'm just throwing a little bit of corn down to my left. And just an odd little tiny bit of micro. It's quite nice down here to my right. It's like that deep, right against the cover. And that side, I've got to come away probably a meter to get the same depth. And at the moment, there's nothing. I haven't seen any signs at all. So, yeah, at the moment, pellet feeder, there we go again. Pretty boring, but for you guys, it's not boring for me because there's lots of carp to be caught. But I'll keep you updated, hopefully. Maybe later on, like I said, we're halfway through. This is a better fish. Quick catch up now, it's, hour and 50 to go. I've probably got about 140. To be honest, I'm just plowing on with the feeder. People have gone down the edge on here and it's not really happening. I've seen no signs at all of fish shallow. To be honest, I might not even come off of this. I've had a nice little spell of some big ones. This is a decent fish as well. But I've just heard Perry Stone's got 200 pound on home ground. On peg 91, which is like a favourable. Obviously, John Harvey won it from 90. They've put another peg in there. And to be honest, just don't think he's going to get beat, to be honest. Hillview is not fishing as probably people expected it, even though it's fishing brilliant. Jack Stamps on peg 60, I think he's going to end up with a decent weight or a big weight. But, you know, I'm sort of doing all right. It's just, it's hard to, like, know, because I've had some sort of 6, 7, 8 pounders in the last 45 minutes. This is another 6 pounder, and that's a good fish on here. So, yeah, awesome fishing. Just ploughing me, you know, just keep ploughing on. And I'm just trying to use the people around me as a guide, really. Billy's gone out shallow to my right with maggots and he's just got bitted out. And you're like, puts you off of going out there, to be honest. And I'm just going to keep ploughing on with this. I know it's a bit boring for you guys, but obviously, can't really help that. So I reckon I'm just going to click that round now because I reckon that's 50 odd pound in that net. So yeah, I reckon I've got 150, 160. As long as me, as long as I've clicked well. But they do go absolutely mental when you're, I'm fishing 019 hook lengths and that one's just done me hook length. I've put, I'm actually fishing with three red maggots on the hook at the moment as well. I don't want to really tell anybody, but that's what I'm doing. And that seems to be working quite well. It's just not quick enough. I know it's brilliant fishing, but to try and win, you know, to try and catch 300 pound, which I think you're gonna need to win, it ain't quite quick enough. It's awesome fishing, but it is, unfortunately, I've come away from the island a bit. That seems to be pretty good as well. Coming like a meter and a half off. Don't know why. Just don't, there's no tails or anything up over there. So most bites are still coming. I've not had many bites where I've actually put the rod down and it's gone round. You've actually got to wait a bit. And all I would like to see is, like, where I've been loose feeding them maggots real heavily from the start, is to see some, you know, some swirls or maybe carp gobbing on the top, which is what they do when they're on a mirror on maggots, and it ain't happening. I just started, obviously, last sort of 45 minutes, I've just started chucking some bait down the edge, either side. But it just, I don't know, it just don't seem like it's going to happen. So yeah, unfortunately, it is like a bit of a feeder job. I've got my short line there, it's a top kit. And a bit that could be. I'm gonna have to have a look on it in a minute. But looking round, it's just not. It ain't happening. But I will look out shallow, even though I've not seen any signs. I will look out there just in case. You never know. It might be solid and just not giving ourselves away. But at the moment, just keep going on the feeder. You get little spells like, you know, with like a few quick bites and then nothing. And obviously people around you, what happens is they come off the pole, they go back out on the feeder, and that seems to affect my line. Even though I've sort of just ploughed on, it just seems to affect my line as well. I think it just thins the fish out a bit, unfortunately. And Just going through the motions, really. But I'd love to see, by now, really, I was hoping to see some fish, like, on that maggot line. And it ain't going to happen, I don't think. I keep looking and hoping and praying. But, and like I said, with Todber, it's big weight matches. And, you know, something needs to happen on this pole line. And even on this feed line, you know what I mean? It goes round, but it's not good enough to try and beat, like, to try and catch between 250 and 300 pound, which I think, like I said at the start, I think you're going to need to win this, like, between 280 and 320, something like that. maybe even a bit more, because on home ground they are definitely bigger fish on there. And you just need that little bit of room, you know, you just ain't got it on here, unfortunately. It's still mega fishing, you know, you can't knock it, it's mega. And yeah, just keep going, and fingers crossed I'll have a run late on the pole. Well, just gone down the edge, and I've had three and lost a decent one. That's down to me right, and it's really nice against the bank there, to be fair. It's like just over 2 foot against the reeds, where to my left it is a bit different, and it's not very nice at all. I put that down for £2, so I reckon I've probably got, well, probably around, if I'm got my nets right, I reckon 160, 170, I would say, maybe. But like I said, there's some real nice pegs in, you know, home ground. They're going to be, if they're catching down the edge, and I've been told there's a few people catching down the edge, they will be hard to beat, because the average stamp on them lakes, this has to be really good here, and it is, it's good, but it's not good enough. I'm not saying that. Oh, just ping that one off. That was a good fish as well, that. But it is starting to, like, well, there's definitely a few fish there anyway. So I'm just going to start chucking a bit of corn and a bit of meat off the end of my keep nets with the top kit plus a short four. And I think I'm just going to go between, really, trying to catch a load of fish short now. Just gutted about that. Just on dead maggots down the edge. I've brought a load of maggots with me. Obviously, I've sacked the shallow off because that was just solid with the wrong fish. There was no carp there. No one's really caught shallow on here. I think there will be a few areas on the other lakes where they maybe catch shallow, and they'll be the pegs that you really wanted today. You know, if you can catch them shallow out of your hand, like we all know, same with carp and F1s, you're going to be hard to beat. And unfortunately on this lake, it just doesn't, well, on this end anyway, it hasn't happened. You know, I really thought they might, but with every peg in, the pressure, you know, the lake's fishing brilliant, but, you know, this lake, you know, on its day can win matches, but it just doesn't seem to have that, not today. That feeder's been good, but not, like, good enough, and this needs to be good now. A bit more bait in. Not seen any signs down there, which is all, you know, which is sometimes better, because you don't actually see in the fish, you don't always catch them, but it is nicer because it just goes straight down, nice depth, flat bottom, but they're not coming in the numbers that you need, certainly not at the moment anyway. Got one on now, though. Definitely want some bait down there. You know, I've come back. Got a big cab pot on there. Just chuck a bit of corn short. Not too much. So we got about an hour and 20 to go. And said probably 160, 170 I've got at the moment. I'm not messing about down the edge. I'm fishing 17 Jura, size 12, XSH, single bit of corn over dead maggots at the moment. I can always put a bunch of deads on, but This is where you can do the damage if they come. Not a bad fish. Give him £6. And I would say, really, you know, fishermen are qualifiers. As they go, it don't get better than Todber. You know, there's probably, I reckon there's probably 20 pegs you could have actually tried to qualify from today, which is amazing for a fisher qualifier or any qualifier. But with the weights, you need, like I said this morning, you need to fish in a certain way to catch those weights. I was just not going to catch them. That feeder would have had to have been absolutely rigid, really. It's been good, but not rigid enough to try and get the front, you know, try and beat the front runners. Oh, a bit of a slapper then, Billy. But he's just lost one, I think fouled hooked. So I'm just going to keep that little bit of bait going in on that short line. A little bit of meat and corn. That's what I've decided to fish there, meat and corn. We all know how, you know, meat can be absolutely, absolutely lethal. It's just a pity about the edge to my left, really. It's just not, when I plumbed up, it's just not right. It was really shallow, right in tight, and there's no light. I like the depth against the bank rather than away from the bank, especially this time of year. And it was like, when I plumbed up, I thought I was gutted, really. I'd like to have gone from one side to the other with the same float right against the bank, and, you know, maybe caught one side, gone to the other, and I just felt I wasn't going to ever do that today. But we'll keep going, and obviously I'll give you a bit of an update in like half an hour, and hopefully some, you know, they will turn up on one of these lines. But at the moment, it's just definitely not quick enough to catch the weight that you that you're probably going to need, unfortunately. But even so, I've had a mega day's fishing, whatever happens, which you always do at Todber. And yeah. We'll keep going, and fingers crossed it all kicks off in the next 30 seconds, hopefully. Well, I've just come short on a top kit and a half. Well, top kit and a short four, and it's been all right, actually. I probably should have gone on it a little bit earlier, but don't think you're going to win. But I think someone just said there's a few couple of people with like six keep nets in already, which is ridiculous. This is a good fish I've just caught there. So I'm just sort of just fishing a 4x14 inline diamond, meat and corn mixed together. And I was throwing it, and I just put like a big cab pot on, and I've added him straight away. Nice ghosty. Oh, was a nice ghosty. Should have had him. Absolutely tore off that thing. Same elastic as what I'm using down the edge. 17 drawer, size 12 XSH. 019 main line. 017 bottoms. Nice fish, that one. Bit of an orangey belly to him. So I'm probably getting near sort of getting on for £200, I'd have thought. Somewhere close to it now. Depending. So I'm going to put him down for. Yeah. So I got, getting on for 200. So great fishing, but don't think I'm in the race. So just starting to pile a bit of bait in. It's a nice depth there. I actually fished there because when I plumbed up, there was a real nasty little shelf on another joint out. And I said to Zolt, I don't like it. And there was like a real steep shelf. So it's decision time, whether the fish on top of it or below it. and I fished on top of it. Now, obviously, by the looks of that, I've made the right choice. I just want to stay out of deep water. Obviously, this is where you can do the weights and whether I should have come on it a bit earlier now, I don't know. But my favourite sort of fishing, meat and corn, big hooks, they'll get better. Now, I said, them old big ones make such a massive difference on your clicker. You know, you get 8 or 9 pounders here and there, and the big tab pot on, filling it up, not messing about, just topping it in, just trying to lift that over the top, follow it down. I mean, them diamonds are absolutely mustard at this sort of fishing. Nice thick hollow bristle, can't break them. So that's short four. Like to have fished a normal four, but it just went off and I didn't like it. And I think it's actually all right. It could have been the other way around. Perhaps I should have set another rig up for down the shelf as well, but that was such a nice depth there. It's like 3.5 foot. It just stops you foul looking them. But they don't always come up on it. But it needs to be like, you know, so for me to claw this back now, this needs to be absolutely rigid, and it just don't seem like it's going to happen. I know people watching this are probably thinking, actually, Des, Christ, £200. But it is it is exceptional weights here. And it's hard to get your head around it, really, the amount of weights that they do here. I think Perry Stone's going to take some beating. He's drawn that new peg 91 on home ground. And honestly, you've got a little bit of room. And when they come down the edge in short air, it plumbs up so nice, them pegs. Where this lake's a bit different. Home ground is like nice and shallow. You can sort of find the depth that you want. And when they rock up, it's unbelievable. Where you can tell from this, you know, I've just had two real quick. And then it's like, it's the same down the edge when I went down the edge. I had like 4 quick bites. Obviously, I'm still feeding that. But this needs to be proper solid to claw it back, even have a chance of clawing it back. But, oh yeah, that was on the drop. So I'm not feeding by hand, I'm just going to feed it by the pot. That's what I tried feeding it by hand, it just felt wrong. So I've got proper gear on here. Just imagine if they were there properly, you'd have a mega, mega weight. And that's why I fish there, you know what I mean? I've come to try and win, and whatever happens, I've had a mega day. I'm going to have to get Zolt to get me another keep net in a minute. He is my... Oh, it's behind me. Thank you, Zolt. He's brought me enough food today. He's looking after me as per normal. So thanks for that, Zolt. So I'm just cupping that in. Literally, if I go about 2 foot past where I'm fishing, it actually goes down about a foot. So I think cupping it on there, keep it nice and tight. Anything that's coming up that shelf, I know it's rock hard bottom. You're not gonna, you know, I've not even fouled up one there. I I just wish it was obviously a little bit better. Just feels like if that kicked off there, you'd have a chance. And some people will, you know, some people on some pegs will just get one a chuck on these lines. Oh, look at that, drag the elastic out of that. That was a big fish as well, that. Probably fouled up that. So I've just got some 7mm meat, some F1 corn. Probably kicking myself a bit. I probably should have come on that earlier. Nice short line. Yeah, and we got what we got left. 50 minutes left. So there's still a chance of catching, you know, quite a lot more fish if this kicks off. I just don't think it's going to this lake at the moment. No one's like, maybe the end peg down there in the wind. You know, you'd fancy that today, even though it's not the best area normally. With that wind blowing down, it will make a massive difference today. And I'm sure if the wind had been blowing up this end, this would have been even better today than what it already. It's still good. Alex Murray's drawn the end peg up there, 75. He's catching well, he's caught all day, but I don't know what weight he's got. I really thought that was going to kick off for a minute there. So annoying, even though the fishing's brilliant, you just want it to see, like, literally just go under every single chuck, because you know you're in the race then. But knowing this venue like I do, there will be people literally getting one a chuck on that line down the edge, and to try and compete with it is really, really difficult. Gonna throw a few bits of corn in there, just make it a bit of noise, see if that makes any difference. A bit of bait down the edge. Straight away on that, look. Lovely fish, you know. I just love that meat and corn fishing when it goes. Thing is amazing as well, there's no silverfish there. I've had one little skimmer there where I fed maggots. It's just absolutely rigid with little skimmers. Fish, £5 that one. Oh, animals, honestly. Perfectly hooked. That's what's so nice on that shelf. If they do have it, it is deadly. So go back in again. Little 7mm meat. Not burying it or anything like that. Too good for that. So I'm just going to carry on with this. Obviously, keep feeding down the edge. I've give up to me left. That was when I plumbed up. I just didn't fancy that at all. In hindsight, I wish I'd probably use this rig down to me left a bit and just fed two lines at this depth, but it's too late to mess about that now. Hindsight's a wonderful thing when you're fishing the match and, you know, maybe sort of gone from one line to the next. But you are, you know, you have got to fish a certain way here to win, and if it don't work, it's very, very difficult to come back. If not impossible. So I'm just going to lift and drop. Is that one on the drop, that one? I really thought that was going to really kick off there. Like literally hook one, put a bit of bait on, feed. You know, 20 seconds, 30 seconds, you get, you know, get another bite, and it's just not, it's just not been like that at all. It's been not out on any line, to be honest. All, everybody's had the same on this lake. It's just not kicked off as I thought it might. Make a bit of noise, a bit of corn, a bit of lifting, dropping, feed a bit of bait down that edge. Well, we've got about 35 minutes to go now, and that sort of top kit and a short four is good. I've had some nice fish there, to be fair. This is a nice ghosty. It's never like, I know it's crazy to say it, it never feels like you're going to catch the weight you need, but it's lovely fishing. Got to keep, I was cupping and then nothing, I've started throwing. It's like they're coming in off the bottom. A couple of the big ones like this one I've actually caught on the drop. These are the ones that can, like, you know, help you out. But, you know, I've just put my fifth carp net in. But I've heard that Perry Stone's got like 10. That's a real nice fish, that. Get him for the camera. Zolt, that's a beauty. That's Ghostbusters. That's a really nice fish. Unfortunately, I'm not going to hold him up, folks, because I need to get back out there and it's probably getting on for £9, that. So yeah, just lovely bit of fishing short, to be honest. But they're definitely coming in off the bottom. I've got to keep, I did have a few throwing, cupping, and then it's just like, you've got to throw a bit of corn. And yeah, just seems to like bring them in. It's like they're coming in off the bottom. It's just not, I mean, it's not fast enough, and I don't think there's anything you can do apart from just enjoy what's going on and try and sort of win the section. But I just don't know what's going on this lake, to be honest. Zolt says I'm doing all right, but he could have been a lot worse. He could have been down some of the other lakes that are off site, and I think you wouldn't have had an open hell down there. But that's fishing, you know, you pay your money, you take your chance, and on any of these qualifiers, we all know that. And Todber is probably one of the, I would say, like I said earlier, it's probably one of the best places to actually try and qualify, because there's lots of pegs you can have a chance from. The fishing's that good. like now you just want it to, I just want it to fire under really quick. And it just, yeah, there you go. I mowed that one on, didn't I? Lovely setup that, that 17 drawer, look for like, yeah, look at the size of them, that's the ones you want. I'm kicking myself a bit, because you just think, should I come in earlier, but I don't know. Nice fish though. Throw a bit of corn down there. But it looks like I made the right choice on that line anyway. These are the ones that are swimming around shallow all day. And they come into the edges down, you know, short. Soon put a weight together with them babies. So top kit plus a short four, bit of corn, bit of meat. Just wanted to go like whack immediately. Meat is so good. I know some venues don't allow it, and but when they have it, it's so lush. Fantastic little bites. It's like I've got to sit there for just a little bit. It was really weird because the first few I had throwing, then I put a pot on which was good. I caught like four or five doing that, and then ever since it's like I've got to throw like five or six grains of corn in. Yeah, look at that result. There's a plane going over and it's nearly touching the ground. The only thing is, it don't seem to be any of the smaller carp coming up on this shelf. It seems to be the bigger ones, which is nice. They'll be nice to get them other like 2-pounders mixed in, and it's not happening on that line. So I'm gonna throw a few more grains of corn in. Bit of noise. Yeah, I can't. Just flick it out past, let it come in. Just willing it to go under, but it won't. It's just not enough there to sort of make the difference. And I think the shallow fishing, I think if they'd have been here in numbers or had a go today, the shallow fishing, you would have caught shallow and, you know, they'd have been swirling on the bait. It's just not happened on here today. Absolutely flew under. All good fish though, all decent fish. That's where them short fours can come in, you know, when you're fishing like this and you want to get in a certain depth. Don't fish with them much, but they do have their day. nice fish here. These are the ones. These are the ones you want. Well, 8 minutes to go now, so I've been told by Zolt, and yeah, I'm still catching, still having a mega day's fishing. Had some real nice fish. I would say now I've probably got upwards of I would like to think I got 250, I would think. Let me just get that a minute. Yeah, 250. Something like that, which is, you know, incredible day's fishing. But it's definitely not enough to win. This short line is awesome. I love this sort of fishing. Flicking it. It is short to be fair. Just chucking in corn mostly with a little bit of meat. I've just got, you know, you just get an odd bite really. It's definitely not in, get one. You've got to sit there, be patient, flick it out a little bit. That one then I literally had, never had a bite for probably 3 or 4 minutes, chucked 5 or 6 of grains of corn in, flicked it out past, it literally had it as it hit the bottom. But it's just not happened on this lake to compete, I think, with the winners. No chance today. But it's been mega fishing, you know, what you expect from Todber, really. Incredible fishing for everybody. I think most people, I think everybody today would have caught between, you'd like to think, between 100 and 150 pounds on this lake, just fishing a certain way. You know, it's crazy, really. But to catch the weights you need to win, it is a different ball game. You have to fish a certain way. And that's what I've tried to do, you know, on the feeder as well. Not fish the ground bait method, I fished the pellet feeder because I thought, well, if I'm going to have it, and I've caught more than most on the feeder on this lake. So it's obviously worked, but down the edge in this line, it's been good, but it's never been good enough to compete, unfortunately. So really, I've just had a mega day's fishing. I've caught some nice fish here, to be fair. I've caught quite a lot. I'm not getting that many bites, but most of the fish I'm catching are decent fish. You know, you're only fishing like probably a metre and a half past my keep nets, which is absolutely crazy, really. But it's about depth of water and obviously the bottom you're fishing on. The edges, really, no one's bagged up down the edges on this lake. I think if you'd have had a little bit of room, then it's a different ball game altogether. But even this, like you can probably tell, it's not, I'm not getting any indications. It's literally just the odd bite. You know, I think, like I said, they're just coming up that shelf, swimming along the shelf, and there's just not enough of them to catch the weights you need. But hopefully, you know, hopefully win me lake or me section or whatever like that, you know. That's what it's all about. I've enjoyed it. It's been frustrating because obviously I want to win, but you can't do it. You can't do it unless the fishing is absolutely exceptional. And you've still got to get it right, you know. Maybe I've not done it right. Maybe I should have fished meat shallow. Who knows? I don't think the fish have been shallow. There's not been many fish topping or on the top, moving around. Not even foul looking them, really. But it's awesome. This is awesome. When it flies under there, it's absolutely brilliant. So we only got a few minutes to go, and what I'll do, we'll have a little chat afterwards and then obviously weigh in and let you know what's happened and all that sort of stuff, really. So bear with us and we'll let you know as soon as we can. the match is finished now. Obviously, I've just packed everything up. It's taken quite some time to weigh in because everybody's caught an absolute pile of carp. I've had a mega day's fishing myself. I've ended up with 267 pound, and that was very close to what I thought. I was really good on the clicking counter today. I've had 50 odd pound in each of my carp nets and a few silvers. But just talk you through the match, really. Obviously, I've fished a pellet feeder, as you've obviously seen quite a lot of the match. Maybe a little bit too long, I'm not sure. But looking at everybody else on the actual lake, they have come short earlier than me, and they fished down the edges, and it hasn't really happened. They've had a little spell, and then it's just gone off. I probably, in hindsight, I wish I'd have come on that top kit and a short four a little bit earlier with meat and corn. Obviously, you've seen that during the film, what I've done, and that's been good. Not numbers of fish, but the stamp of fish. There's been some 6 to 8, 9 pounders there. Not loads, admittedly. And I really thought at one time it might get going, but it was never going to be enough to win. I mean, Perry Stone has absolutely blitzed the match with 430 pound from one of the areas that I would love to have been on, which was peg 91 on home ground. It's one of the new pegs they put in. So well done to him. I think you'll probably want a big 200 to three, a low 300 to actually come second or third in the match. I don't really know the results yet, but I've won Ash Lake. I've won me section. I don't think I could have done much more. I have lost a few fish today, but you always do on Todber. They are an absolute nightmare on the feeder, especially. Obviously this, you know, when you watch the film, I hope you've picked up some great tips. And obviously Todber is very, very special at the moment. It's absolute peak. I mean, every fish in the lake seems to feed. But once again, great day out with Zolt. It's been sunny, it's been nice, caught loads of carp, even though it's a bit frustrating because you know you're going to need a big weight to actually win. But for a qualifying round of the Fishermania, Todber has to be one of the best. You know, this morning, I would say there's probably 15 to 20 pegs that I would have taken to try and catch the weight you need to win. And that, for me, a qualifier is amazing. There's not many venues like that in the country. So there you go. Anyway, I hope you enjoy the film. Tight lines, and don't forget to like and hit the subscribe button.